Death Stranding can be overwhelming thanks to the many features and systems it throws at you, but actually understanding everything will help you a ton to get the most out of each delivery and make them all easier too. So in this video, I will share a ton of tips and tricks to help you out and some things you want to get and unlock as soon as possible. No story spoilers, of course, in this video, so let's get into it. Would be awesome if you could leave a like on the video as it shows your support. And let's go. First things first, make sure you prepare yourself before going out on a cargo delivery. Visit your private room and drink Monster Energy, for example, to get a stamina buff that will totally come in handy. Here you will also refill your bottle that fully restores your stamina while on the road. Your BB will be happy again and you restore your blood levels. Later on, it also restores your battery and ammo capacity. The point is that it's always smart to visit your private room when you can and make use of the extra bonuses. And speaking of extra bonuses, you totally want to play Death Stranding online because it will make your life way easier. Not only will you see a lot of structures from other players that will help you a ton so you don't have to build them yourself, but you can also get stuff from the shared locker that will save you some materials. So always check the shared locker at the terminal before fabricating the equipment yourself. You will sometimes even find items that you cannot craft yet, or better versions of equipment that are very useful. Another tip for if you are in the shared locker menu is to grab all the lost cargo, even if you do not plan to deliver it to the destination. Just select all the lost cargo and then drop them all on the ground. You can select multiple at the same time as well to do it faster and then hit offload. Now you can immediately deliver all the cargo again. Sometimes you have to first go out of the menu and then activate the terminal again to make the delivery. And while you do not get the maximum amount of likes, you will get that by really delivering the cargo to the destination. Doing it this way, that is way easier, will still give you a ton of points so you can easily rank up and in the end even carry more cargo. So totally check all the shared lockers at every terminal and deliver all the lost cargo immediately to easily rank up. And even if you already visited the location once, there will still be new lost cargo as time goes on. So check it frequently. With this tactic, I easily got to rank 50 without really doing anything. And by leveling up, you also can give more likes to structures from other people. Something you totally want to do, because the more likes you exchange, the more of these player structures you see. And again, they are very useful, so you don't have to waste the materials yourself and do not have to carry those structures around yourself. So really, really nice. I will share more tips on how to get a ton of likes in a second, because level 50 is only just the beginning. But let's first touch on a damaged motorcycle that you will see early in the game, because getting this one will obviously speed things up a ton. So you can use this motorcycle by building a generator that you can create with a PCC level 1. Just equip the PCC device and then you want to select the generator by using the D-pad and then build that close to the vehicle. Now just wait until the generator is built and then the motorcycle will be charged. And now you can immediately put some cargo on the vehicle too, and that will really help you a ton to carry more to your destination. And now bam, you are free to use it. And again, that will speed things up a lot, trust me. Later on, you can also craft your own vehicles or grab them from other people in the garage. Totally something you want to do instead of making them yourself, because you can way better use the materials that you can claim at terminals to build roads. In chapter 3, you go to the biggest map in the game where you can actually make roads that will make going from point A to point B even easier, because you skip the otherwise crappy terrain and can use your boost all the time, because when you drive on a road, your battery will not go down. Meaning that you can go way faster to your destination, and trust me when I say that this will be helpful for the rest of the game. So spending materials to build the roads will be very handy. And you can build these roads by bringing a lot of materials to the auto pave stations that you find again in chapter 3. And even if you don't have enough materials to make the road at first, you can always go back to deliver the rest after claiming the materials again from the different terminals. The cool part is though that other players can help you too. It's a collaborative effort to build the roads, so it can totally be that someone else finishes the job after you delivered some materials already. You want to deliver as much materials as possible though, because this is where the likes come in. When you namely build a road or put a ton of materials in the auto paver, then every time someone else uses the road, you will get a notification and also a like. Because that's the thing, when you build something, and also when you like put down a letter, it might appear in other people's game and they can then give you likes in exchange. So at one point I received 300,000 likes upon logging in, because everyone was happy with my road. And this will then also help you a ton to gain levels and get the extra benefits. A car is handy to be able to deliver a lot of materials to the auto pavers, and while you will be able to create one yourself or get it from the garage, you can already get a car way earlier than that by stealing it from the mule enemies. There will be a camp over here on the map early in the third chapter where a lot of mule enemies will drive a car around. So totally take out the enemies first that will attack you, and then you can just steal their vehicle and use it yourself. While it is slower than a motorcycle, a car does have room for more stuff, so it's super handy to deliver a lot of materials to the different structures like the roads. If you leave it though and it still has some cargo inside, then that cargo will be lost, just like the items you just put on the ground and leave behind. So totally keep that in mind, because it's a stolen car, it is not in your possession. You also cannot store it in your garage, sadly, so be careful when it rains, because then the car and the cargo will be destroyed. It of course helps if you put the car under a timefall shelter. So you need to get your hands dirty to get the car from the mule enemies. Using your fist will be key here, and actually a nice attack that you can do to catch the enemies off guard is holding R2 and L2 that you normally do to grip for balance, and then just mash the square to stun the mule enemies, and then you can easily follow up with some nice punches to take them out immediately. Early in chapter 3, after doing a job for Herman Hulst, yes, the ex-managing director of Guerrilla Games, and now actually the head of PlayStation Worldwide Studios, well, he is in Death Stranding 2 in one of the shelters in chapter 3, and he gives you the Bola gun after you do a delivery for him. And this is the first gun in the game. It's pretty nice to instantly take out the mule enemies, but the downside is that the enemies will get up real fast after you fire the gun. So using your fist is still smarter in my opinion, until you of course get the non-lethal assault rifle in, I think, chapter 5. During combat, your cargo might get hit by an enemy and get damaged, or when you just fall on the ground and drop a ton of cargo that way. That's why it's always smart to carry a container repair spray with you, so you can repair your cargo before you deliver it. This only works for the container damage though, so keep that in mind, but what you can actually do is make the container spray at the terminal of the shelter and then use it before you go and deliver the goods. This way you don't have to carry the item all the time, while you still make sure that your cargo is not damaged when you deliver it. You of course first have to be able to fabricate equipment at the terminal before you can do this tactic, but when you like return to a terminal that you've already been to, then this is a great thing for sure. And speaking of cargo and delivering that, another small tip that you are likely aware of, but that you totally want to use as often as possible, is the auto arrange cargo in the cargo management menu. This will make sure that you carry your cargo in the best way possible. Careful though, because some deliveries require the cargo to be horizontal, and in this auto arrange function they don't really care about that, so you gotta think about that yourself, like for example when delivering a pizza. Apart from the mule enemies, you of course also have the BTs as a serious threat, and you will easily see when they are nearby thanks to the rain that appears, and you can of course sneak past them or take them out with a hematic grenade. And later on, you even got other tactics too. Pro tip is to totally try your non-lethal guns against the BTs. Can't show you any footage of that yet because of embargo reasons, but Trust me, it's great. If you don't really like taking out these BTs one by one, then there is another tactic that can make the BT location way easier, and that is just getting caught. It might sound weird, but if you then escape out of the area and you can easily see the area by opening the map. So if you then escape the monster, then the whole area will be clear of BTs, meaning that you can then easily pick up the items that you need for the job without having to worry about the enemies. You can also take out the BT monster if you want, but running away makes it disappear too and doesn't cost a ton of grenades. When the BTs are gone, you can also easily pick up the items again that you might have dropped after being grabbed by the BT. Sure, they will be slightly damaged, but you can repair that by waiting close to a Timefall shelter that unlocks somewhere in Chapter 3. Here you can also wait for the rain to go by, and after visiting the radar station in Chapter 3, you can also see the rain on the map and plan accordingly. Although sometimes the rain will be there for the next 30 minutes or longer, so then you gotta take your losses. If you got some awesome Death Stranding tips and tricks that you discovered while playing, then totally drop them down in the comments below. I totally want to do more videos to help you out, so totally want to highlight your tips and then of course share credits in a future video. Subscribe for everything Death Stranding, I got way more tips and tricks coming your way, and I will keep you up to date on all the updates that are coming to the game too. Like this video to support the channel and check out my other Death Stranding content here by clicking on the screen, including my review for if you haven't watched that yet. For now though, I will speak to you next time and goodbye.